Hello and welcome everyone to a new video presented by Teleskop Service. My name is Thorsten and this is our second video of the Ritchey-Chretien series where I will collimate the telescope. And I will do this collimation with a helper, the TSCOLLIT Collimation Teleskop. So the collimation of a Ritchey-Chretien telescope is pretty straightforward and you have multiple options to do it. The first and most simple one is the use of the TSRC Colli, a little device where I also made a video about. I will put a card on the top here and also a link in the description below so you can check this out. The next step would be this TSCOLLIT Collimation Teleskop, which gives you a higher precision. And there are also other options to do. For example, the use of a holographic laser, which projects concentric circles, where you can also adjust the mirrors. And last but not least, a thing that you always should do is the star test. That means you collimate it with the appearance of a defocused star. That gives you obviously the best result. But the star test, of course, relies on visible stars. So all the other tests are doable on your workbench at home. So you don't have to put the telescope on your mount, you can just have it on the table. That's the very advantage of these procedures. So without further ado, let's get started with the TS-Colli-T. So first of all, we have to remove our focuser. This is because the telescope is designed to be screwed on, and also you have a power plug here, and with this power plug you can't put it into a focuser. But now to mount it on your telescope, when you remove the focuser you have that M117 thread here, but you need a T-thread for that. And therefore we offer you two options. One is the M117 to T-thread adapter, and the other one is an M90 adapter. The M90 is for the 6 and the 8 inch version, and this M117 is of course for the big ones here. Okay, now we have our adapter plate here and now we screw in the collimation telescope. So now we have screwed in our collimation telescope, and here in the end you have a T thread and also a clamp for 1¼ inch accessories. And you get, together with the telescope, you get two eyepieces, a 15 and a 25 millimeter plus eyepiece. So you can do this visual. That means you look through the eyepiece and adjust the mirrors properly. That's one way to go. But here for the video and also for a more convenient use, I would always recommend using a camera and a laptop or something, your PC, because then you can just look at the screen while turning the collimation screws. That's far more easy. So that's my recommendation, but visual is possible. And in addition, you get also some spacers. 1¼ inch spacers that you can put onto the eyepiece or on the camera. The thing is, you don't have a focuser anymore here. That means you have to reach focus by moving the eyepiece or the camera in and out and then tighten the clamp again. That's the way of work here. All right, but before we start the whole procedure, we want to check that the tilt plate here is properly adjusted. So for all the new big telescopes starting from 10 inch, the focuser is decoupled from the primary with this tilt plate. And we want to have it exactly centrical, pointing to the secondary. So the secondary has a central mark, and therefore we can use just a very simple laser. That's just a laser that you may know from Newtonian telescopes. This is also working here. We put it in, tighten it, and then give some power here. So we don't look at the reflection because we don't adjusting the secondary now. We're adjusting only the tilt. And you can do this by just checking that that enlarged laser dot is now hitting the center. And for correctness, we have also to turn the laser, that we ensure that the laser is also symmetrical. Some of the very cheap lasers may have imbalance. That means when you turn the laser, the dot moves around, and this is definitely a problem. So, but here it looks good. If it's pointing not to the middle, you just have to loose the push screws here, these lock screws. And then you can adjust the tilt by turning that middle screw here and just look through the tube where the laser dot is moving. So this procedure is fairly simple for truss tubes. For closed tubes, that's more difficult. Then you have to use an additional mirror where you can look at the at this laser reflection. So that adjustment is only a rough one, to be honest. If you put on a camera, especially a full frame camera, then you may see still a tilt. Then you have to fine tune it again with the star. Okay, now we connect our camera. So just by putting it in here, tighten it gently, just gently, because we have to focus it. And now we start our camera software. Oh, and now we have to, we should power the LED. So with the regulator, you can adjust the brightness of that reflection, and you will need it. You don't need much integration time here or much brightness, because the cameras are so responsive. Oh, one word to the camera. So this one here has an APS-C sensor size, and you see the, yeah, basically the full, the complete image, the full tube here. You can also use smaller cameras like the ASI 120 or some plug-in cameras that came directly in here in that extension tube. But then you see only the very center, then you see only that secondary reflection. That means you can also only adjust the secondary with such a small camera. So I would recommend using your regular imaging camera here. Of course, a DSLR is also working. Just use one of these cameras with bigger sensors. Okay, now we zoom in a bit here. So now what you now see are two important things. The dark spot in the middle, that's important, and we focus on that dark spot. That's just the shadow of the secondary, together with the focuser. And now we change the focus slightly to see that second ring here. Okay, you already see there's an imbalance, so this is decollimated and we have to adjust it. There may be an issue with your particular telescope. And this is the central baffle. At the moment, the central baffle is mounted, and you can also remove that baffle. It's just screwed in. But you have to be very, very careful when doing this. In the first try, I would recommend keeping the baffle in place. The idea is to enlarge that reflection, to enlarge that circle, and also to remove that baffle from the equation. That means if the baffle is tilting somehow, that may affect also the collimation and also that appearance here on the screen. So removing that one gives you a more precise image. Okay, and now the procedure is very simple. We want to adjust the secondary, and we do this by turning the front, these three front collimation screws, only very slightly, only small fractions of a turn, the good thing is you already see what you're doing here on the screen, so no worries, you can't do any harm to your telescope. Just grab one screw and turn it. And now I made maybe a 30th of a turn or something like that, and you see already that was the screw that is messing the collimation up. And now I would say that's already good to go. Let's check out another screw here. So yeah, that's the opposite direction, that makes things even worse. So get back to the starting position like here, and we have a concentric image, which is a perfect starting point for a star collimation for the secondary mirror. And as mentioned, we also have to check the primary. And therefore we reduce the zoom factor, of course. Give it a bit more exposure time to see our background. So now here you see the wall just there in front of the telescope. And what we now do is we focus on, we can now also reduce the light a bit here. Oh yeah, we can just reduce it. And now we focus on that veins of the secondary, that these spider veins. And therefore we can also give it some more zoom here. I have to push it in maybe half an inch or so, and now you see that the veins are in good focus. And what we now adjust is we want to remove that gap here from the outer vein to that reflected vein. It's the same, but this one, this inner one here, is reflected from the primary. And we see that there's a gap here and also here, but this one and this one looks pretty good. So we check out, we have to loosen now the lock screws of the primary. There's always one lock screw in addition to the adjustment screw. These are located here. And now we grab a screw randomly and turn it and see what happens. So not much. Maybe the lower right is a bit better now. Let's check out this screw. And we also do only small turns. It's bigger than on the secondary, but also not that much. Oh, now it's getting worse. Okay, wrong direction. Now we turn it in the other direction. And you see that gap is closing. It's closing even more. And I would say now we are good. We are now completely parallel in line. Maybe even a bit more. Okay, so that looks good. And now we have to tighten the lock screws again. Do not forget to tighten these lock screws, because when you're transporting the telescope out onto your mount, that may otherwise change the collimation. So always tighten the lock screws gently. Well, that's it. That's all of the procedure. It's, you see, because of the magnification and because of that very easy marker here with that spider vein, the procedure is super simple. And now you have a properly set up telescope, one that you can definitely test out under the stars. Normally you should now be at, let's say, 90%. But when you attach the camera, then you can again check that the defocused star is still in shape, it's circular and it's not elongated. Then you will have a properly collimated Ritchey-Chretien telescope, which gives you much fun over a long time. Okay, before closing this video, I just want to mention we have also produced a manual, a written manual for that Kollimation telescope. You can check it out in the webshop under that TS-Justierteleskop telescope. There's a link to this PDF manual. All the steps I did here are also described in that manual, and also the procedure for the 6 and the 8 inch version with a coupled primary. So feel free to check this out. If you have any further questions or comments, feel free to drop a comment below the video. I would really appreciate it. Okay, thank you very much for tuning in, and see you next time. Bye bye.